Here's an AMI This Week shortcut with me, Victoria Nolan. From Calgary, here's part two of our coverage of CNIB's Employment Skills Bootcamp, volunteering.
12 students, 1 week, all expenses paid, equipping them for their employment journey. Hi, my name is Ted Bonar. I'm the program lead with the Career Support and Employment Program with CNIB Foundation, and welcome to the Employment Skills Bootcamp. The volunteering as it relates to employment class teaches participants the power of volunteering. It's important because it expands their personal and professional networks.
If you're just starting out and you don't have a lot of work experience and you need a reference, get a good volunteer reference. As someone who also hires people, I totally will take a volunteer reference.
The teacher of this class is Amber Duje. She has over 25 years experience as a volunteer and now manages CNIB Foundation's volunteer program.
So with the power of volunteering, we're going to be looking to touch on a few aspects. So the first is, why volunteer? People are busy. Why should they make time to volunteer? And how does it actually help with the job search? So I think it's really important to look at why not only people as general volunteer, but why you as an individual want to volunteer. What are you hoping to get out of it? And being really honest. It's wonderful to say, oh, I want to give back to the community. And if that's your motivation, perfect. But if really your motivation is to get a reference letter, that's okay too. If you're looking to build that reference, look at what job you're trying to get. What skills are going to be the most applicable? So if you want to be in administration, chances are maybe you want to do some reception or you want to do some admin background. So you're not going to maybe volunteer at a music festival doing, you know, security. So try and align what you want as your end goal with the organization. And maybe you're really connected to a particular organization, and that's great, that's wonderful, use that. I love animals. A lot of my volunteering tends to go towards animals because I like them. Also because for a while I wasn't allowed to have a dog, so I got to steal other people's. There's challenges with going into being a volunteer with vision loss, we're not gonna lie, but so much of it can be solved by being upfront and honest and just talking. When organizations are hesitant to bring in someone with vision loss, a lot of the time it's just misinformation. So knowing what you need, both as a volunteer, but as someone with vision loss. So if you need this particular technology, be prepared to tell them that. They can help you with that. They can help you get there. And we can also help you if your organization doesn't know how to do that. I know it can be intimidating when you're starting to volunteer to be upfront about what your vision is or what you're comfortable doing, but having that conversation before you show up will hopefully make the experience a lot better. Ask lots of questions. Not every volunteer opportunity is the perfect fit for everyone, and that's okay. It's about asking those questions and finding the organization that's the right fit for you. You know, do you like working alone? Do you want to work with a team? Do you want to make friends? Do you want to be in a traditional office? Do you want to work from home? Those are all really important things to think about before choosing your volunteer opportunity. Because ultimately, that volunteer opportunity can help get you a job, it can help get you a reference, it can help make connections. You know, some of you here live in big cities, some of you live in smaller communities. So I understand that there's different challenges, totally. But I guarantee you there are places to volunteer in your community. When we're looking at resumes as someone who hires, that volunteer opportunity can often fill a gap. We hate seeing gaps on resumes. What do you do when you get the volunteer opportunity? When it all works out and you've got this fantastic opportunity, and the thing is, it's not a job, but treat it as a job. If you want that reference, you have to show up. And I don't just mean show up on time, which please do. I also mean show up personality-wise. Give everything of yourself that you would normally. Don't slack off because, well, it's just volunteering, because it counts.
After this class, students should be enthusiastic in looking for volunteer opportunities as it relates to their employment journey and feel a sense of satisfaction in knowing that they're helping their community.
I also do want to bring up one thing that I heard a couple people say, that they volunteer because it's fun. Doesn't always have to be like, oh, I have to go volunteer. Volunteering can be super fun.
Tune in next week for some practical career training. If people want to learn more, they can reach out to us at CNIB by logging onto our website at cnib.ca or visiting ami.ca.